The thermometers show the temperature in the morning and at 3 p.m. How many degrees warmer was it at 3 p.m.?
Welcome back. Are you ready to solve another math quest? Today we're measuring something we can't see, but we can feel. Any guesses? It's temperature, a measure of how hot or cold something is. Can you think of a time when you've noticed temperature? How about when we wait for food to cool down, wash our hands, or have a fever? We feel it all the time, but how do we measure it? Let's start by looking at how it's written. You've probably seen temperatures written on a weather app or the Weather Channel. It's those numbers that tell how hot or cold it is, and the little circles. Those are units called degrees. We use degrees to measure temperature, just like we use inches to measure length. But instead of writing out the word, we can use the degree symbol, like we use FT for feet. But wait. Degrees aren't on a ruler, a yardstick, or even a measuring tape. So what tool can we use to check the temperature? I think I've got it. A thermometer. No, not like the one a doctor uses. That kind is for checking a person's temperature to see if they have a fever. The kind we need is for measuring how hot or cold things around us are. Hey! Check it out. This thermometer has the symbol for degrees at the top. What's that letter next to it? F. It stands for Fahrenheit, the scale we use to measure temperature. Some thermometers have another scale, C for Celsius, but we'll use Fahrenheit in this lesson. What else do you notice? Yeah. That red line in the middle, it moves up and down to point to different numbers on the side. The higher the number, the hotter it is, and the lower the number, the colder it is. On this thermometer, the numbers start at 0 and go up to 100 with little marks between them. This looks familiar. What do the numbers and marks on the thermometer remind you of? It looks like a ruler when we measure height. Thermometers work in a similar way, but instead of measuring an object, we look at the red line to see which number or little mark it reaches. That's the temperature. Let's try reading some temperatures together. Here's the first one. We'll zoom in to get a closer look. Which number does the red line reach? 80. So we write 80, the degree symbol, and an uppercase letter F. That's 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Warm enough for an outdoor bike ride. Whoa, the red line's moving down. What's the temperature now? It reaches the 30 mark, so 30 degrees Fahrenheit. Cold enough to snow. Grab your pencil and let's read one more. The red line went back up again, but it didn't reach a number this time. It's between 60 and 70. Each little mark is one more degree, so we can count on from the number the red line just passed, which is 60. Count on with me. 61, 62, 63, 64 degrees. Warmer than 30 degrees, but cooler than 80. Awesome job. You're right, Mia. Temperature does change when something gets hotter or colder. So how can we measure how much hotter or colder something gets? By finding the difference between two temperature measurements. It's just like finding the difference between two lengths. Only this time, we take the higher temperature minus the lower temperature. Let's say it was 68 degrees Fahrenheit in the afternoon and 55 degrees by night. To figure out how much it cooled down, we start by finding the higher temperature. We know that's 68 degrees because it's the greater number, and the red line is higher up on the thermometer. Then we subtract 55. How much colder did it get? That's it. 68 minus 55 equals 13. It got 13 degrees colder by night. Great job. Wow, we learned a lot about measuring temperature today. Are you ready to put it all together and solve this math quest? The thermometers show the temperature in the morning and at 3 p.m. How much warmer was it by 3 p.m.? Okay, this is another quest with two parts, but we know how to do both. First, write down the temperatures on each thermometer. Look closely at where the red line reaches, and don't forget to count on using the little marks if it isn't right on a number. Turn to the last page in your guided notes. Pause here to write down the two temperatures, and then we'll review it together. What's the temperature in the morning? The red line just passed 60, so we count on from there. 61, 62. 62 degrees. And the temperature at 3 p.m.? 70 degrees. The red line is right next to the 70 mark. Nice. On to part two. All we need to do now is find the difference. Pause to set up the problem and subtract. We get 8 degrees by taking the higher temperature, 70, minus the lower temperature, 62. We regroup 110 for 10 ones. 10 minus 2 is 8, and there's no tens left. That means it was 8 degrees warmer by 3 p.m. All right, we're ready to check our work. Write our final answer on your math quest while I input our answer. Fantastic work today! We solved another math quest, and we learned how to read thermometers. Remember, every problem has a solution, and we've got the skills to solve it. See you next time! Hey, hey.